When was the last time that you were stressed? Was it last month, last week, maybe today? And how long did that stress last? Was it just a few hours before a deadline, or did it last longer? 8 out of 10 US adults report being stressed on at least a daily basis. And in my eyes, that's a problem because 80% of all illnesses and diseases, anything from the flu to cancer, is related to chronic stress. Depression, inflammation, and mitochondrial function are some of those conditions related to that chronic stress. We've all probably heard of depression. Inflammation, though, is your body's immune response to an injury or an illness, and that's a good thing in the short term. But if that response is prolonged, that can actually increase your risk for developing a disease. Similarly, mitochondrial functioning is a good thing that provides energy to your body. But when that mitochondria starts to dysfunction, that can increase the stress within the cell, and again, put your body at risk for more diseases. So these conditions, these mental health conditions, inflammation and mitochondrial function, are all associated with each other, meaning that if you have one or at a higher risk for having one, you're more likely to develop the other ones as well. And just to put into perspective how devastating these can be and why my research focuses on these, is that all these conditions are common pathologies or causes in 6 of the top 10 leading causes of death in the United States. In 2017, that accounted for just around 3 million deaths. So now that we're all sitting in our chairs, maybe a little more stressed than we first came in, and definitely aware of that stress and how it's impacting our health, where do we go from here? We'll take a deep breath. I believe there's a simple and cost-effective method for reducing your stress and improving your health, and that's through yoga. Yoga can be easily administered to a large group of people, and anyone can do it. Anyone from an older adult to a pregnant woman to you guys right now sitting in your chairs. Yoga is also unique because it incorporates multiple different components, including breathing, mindfulness, and physical activity. The physical activity components are really interesting because physical activities, such as walking and running, have been shown to improve all of these health conditions. There's also strong evidence to show that yoga can improve your stress and depression. However, there's a lack of research looking at yoga's impact on this inflammation and mitochondrial function. The goal of my research is to look at how yoga impacts all of these health conditions, and we're hoping to see improvements based on the physical activity components of yoga and through the associations of all the different conditions. The goal of my research is to help you guys reduce your stress and improve your health for as long as possible. And I'm excited to find out if yoga is a way to do just that. Thank you.